In the last 2 weeks, the activity at a volcano best known for being somewhat of a Russian equivalent of Mount Saint Helens began intensifying its eruptive activity. As the primary lava dome of the erupting Bezymianny volcano grew larger and larger due to an influx of new molten rock in the lava dome core, it became increasingly unstable. This resulted in periodic small collapses of the dome, creating an ever-increasing number of pyroclastic flows and ash emissions. Then, on April 7, 2023, at around 5:38 p.m. local time, a far more powerful explosion occurred. As a plume of ash shot high into the atmosphere, superheated and energetic gas currents were released from the lava dome as it underwent a small-scale collapse in what is known as a pyroclastic flow. These pyroclastic flows traveled at least 5 kilometers to the east-southeast based on the continuing thermal signatures the superheated deposits gave off as they cooled. The associated cloud of ash rose to a height of 12.8 kilometers or 42,000 feet while drifting to the east-southeast. The vast majority of this eruption was over within 15 minutes as eruptive activity drastically dropped thereafter, producing far smaller and intermittent explosions. What had just occurred was the largest volcanic eruption Bezymianny had produced since May 28th of 2022, when a similar sequence generated an approximately 15-kilometer-high eruption plume. Both of these eruptive sequences would best be classified as Merapi-type Vulcanian eruptions, where a partial lava dome collapse occurs, causing highly pressurized gas to be released and fall back to the ground as a superheated pyroclastic flow, with all of this occurring in association with Vulcanian explosion. This Vulcanian eruption left behind a discernible layer of ash visible from satellite, which covered an area of several thousand square kilometers and caused the associated eruption plume to drift at least 2,000 kilometers to the east. As a result, the alert level of Bezymianny was raised from orange to red by KVIRT. However, less than 24 hours later, it was lowered back from red to orange as the highly explosive paroxysm ended, shifting back to moderately explosive activity. For context, the Bezymianny volcano is located in east-central Kamchatka, where it is 350 kilometers north-northeast of Petropavlovsk-Kamchatsky. Bezymianny is located in a highly volcanically active section of Kamchatka, where, in about the same area as New York City, are 5 active volcanoes, 4 of which have produced historical eruptions, in addition to 2 dormant volcanoes. Bezymianny is the smallest and youngest volcano of this group, as its modern volcanic cone only began forming 5,000 years ago. Before 1955, Bezymianny was incorrectly thought to be an extinct volcano. This is how it received its name, which roughly translates to unnamed, indicating the very low threat local scientists once thought this volcano posed. Then, after around 1,000 years of dormancy, the volcano awoke on October 22nd of 1955. Over the next several months, a large body of magma intruded into its southeast flank, destabilizing the entire edifice. Then, on March 30, 1956, 0.5 cubic kilometers of the volcano dramatically collapsed to the southeast, sending a massive landslide and pyroclastic flows up to 23 kilometers distant. This Plinian eruption was essentially what Mount St. Helens would produce 24 years later, albeit with some minor differences. Bezymianny's 1956 eruption and collapse thus left behind a large horseshoe-shaped collapse scar in addition to causing the volcano to lose 185 meters in height. Since this major eruption in 1956, Bezymianny has continued to almost continuously erupt, albeit with some pauses, some of which lasted more than a year. Most of its eruptive activity during this time span has consisted of Vulcanian explosions and small lava dome collapses. These both occurred from its ever-growing lava dome, which has largely filled in a section of the existing collapse scar. However, since material from this lava dome will continue to be funneled downslope in the direction of the collapse scar, it is prone to producing more large ash plumes from small to moderate volume lava dome collapses. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.